Sometimes you learn things the easy way. Sometimes the hard way. With me, it's always the hard way. This story isn't any different. You know. Starts with a dark and stormy night. This is upstate New York, after all. I was just sitting in my office, smoking a cigarette like a badass. And then all of a sudden, she walked in. No, not her. She's just Ava, my assistant. She doesn't quite fit with the genre.
Oh, yeah.
Papa loves mambo.
She was a tall glass of champagne, cool, expensive tastes. Intoxicating, to say the least. Probably dangerous.
Hello, detective. My name is Scarlett Riviera. You just have to help me, Mr. Roughbuckle.
Please, just Ace. The last name can be a little much. Anyway, what can I do for you, Ms.?
It was Mrs. until this morning. My husband's been murdered.
What a shame.
I found him in the library floor this morning, and his wretched mother thinks it was me. I just don't know what to do. I need somebody to clear my name.
Oh, come on. Don't cry. I'm sure I can handle it.
Ace, if you can clear my name, I'll do anything for you.
Anything, eh?
Well, oh boy, boss! We got ourselves a case, huh? It's gonna be great! Can I come? Can I come?
Yeah, you can come. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Alright, yeah, you can come! You can come! Just stay out of my way.
Okay.
Better yet, leave the gun here.
It's just so horrible. Who could have done this to my poor Geraldo?
My God. Looks like this man's been shot, stabbed in the chest, strangled, poisoned, and he feels a little damp.
I'd say the approximate time of death was exactly 13 hours, 48 minutes, and 16 seconds ago. I would say the fatal wound came from the beating over the head with a blunt object the exact same size, shape, and density of
a candlestick.
A candlestick in the living room? Who could have thought of that?
I don't know, Scarlett, but it certainly is a clue. Now, before we go any further, Scarlett, I need an alibi from you.
Well, at the night of the murder, I was having dinner with a friend. He can vouch for me.
He?
Just a friend. Are you my friend, Mr. Roughbuckle?
Oh, well, I don't know.
Because I'd like you to be.
Oh, my lady.
Hey, boss! You will not believe the best lead that I got! Someone outside? Oh my God, you won't believe who she was. She approached me just now.
Hey, that's great. How about you go back out there and I'll be there in a few minutes.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
All right, bye-bye. Now, where were we?
Again, you hussy! And who the hell is that?
I'm Inspector Roughbuckle, and the pleasure's all yours, I'm sure. I'm, sorry about your loss, Ms.
Riviera. And that's my son! Oh, my poor Geraldo hasn't been dead more than a day and you're already after another one?
Oh, well, if you'll excuse me, I'll get back to solving this case. Before I was so rudely interrupted by Ethel, I had a feeling I was about to crack this case. I seem to have stumbled into some tension. My keen detective intuition told me it had something to do with family troubles. Well, I, seem to have stumbled into a bit of a family affair. I'll, leave you to be, then.
Hey! Help me up! Hey! Men.
So there I was. Pulled away from the woman I love and instead walking down some dirt back alley with my inadequate, but enthusiastic assistant.
Hey, boss, I got a question for you.
What is it, kid?
You never told me why you wanted to become a private dick.
Oh, what do you want, Ava? My life story? I can give it to you in four words. Big ideas, small results.
Was
than a line from Flashpoint Night.
Okay, Rosie the Riveter, whatever you say. Now, what's this lead you were talking about?
Well, I was waiting outside just like you told me, and then a woman approached me who claimed to be Scotland's sister Catherine, and then she had a lead for us, but we gotta be discreet. So, we're gonna go meet her on the church on the corner.
Hey, big guy. You Ace Roughbuckle?
How do you know my name?
I was told to give you these. Said it might be of some importance to you.
What the? Wait, how did he? That was weird. What could this mean?
It's Mr. Ribeiro with another woman!
I can see that, you nitwit. I mean, what does it mean for the case?
Well, think about it, boss. If Mr. Ribeiro was with another woman, he could have been cheating on Scarlett, and Scarlett could have found out and killed him in blind anger.
How dare you make such an accusation? Scarlett is a wonderful woman. She's kind, smart, beautiful, and to top it all off, she has a magnificent pair of breasts. I won't see you accusing her without good reason. Now let's go talk to that lead you were talking about.
Ah, Ava. Nice to see you again. Is this the assistant you were talking about earlier?
No, I'm afraid you have that backwards. I'm Detective Roughbuckle. I'm the one in charge of this investigation. This twerp you see before you is my assistant, Ava. Now, what can you do for us, Ms.?
Elwood. Catherine Elwood. It's nice to meet you.
Good to meet you, too. Milkshake?
No, I'm lactose intolerant.
Just one sip?
No, you don't understand. If I have dairy, I get farty and bloaty. It's not pretty.
Oh, that sounds gross. All right. About this lead we're talking about.
Yes, this horrible business about my sister's husband. You see, I'm afraid that there's something she's not telling you. Her marriage, it wasn't a happy one, and I fear that he may have looked for comfort elsewhere. I don't know how far he would have gone to keep it a secret, and I don't know how far she would have gone to get revenge.
And just like that, my world stopped on a dime. Or was it a quarter? Anyway, here was a dame telling me that the dame I was falling for had some nefarious intentions. A Delilah disguised as a Madonna. It just couldn't be true. It couldn't be true!
Oh, well, thank you so much, Miss Elwood, on your help. This is certainly gonna help in our investigation. Thank you!
I mean, how could it happen like this? She had everything. She had the rack. She had the good looks. She had the rack.
That's okay, all the needs. Time to go.
I can't believe that she won't look past the breast and accept the fact that she might actually be involved in this.
And I can't believe you would blame an innocent woman. We have no proof.
Yes, we do! Isn't it kind of strange that her husband's only been dead a day and she's already all over you?
I'll have you know that even the most untrustworthy people in this country have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
I heard she pursued it in all directions!
What are you saying, man? I'll have you know that Humphrey Bogart came second to me in a handsome man competition. Plus, the trench coat gets all the ladies. Why are you so jealous? You are. You're jealous, aren't you?
I'm jealous of her? I'm just upset that you just never take me seriously! I'm doing this by myself. I don't need you.
And there I was, losing the one person who I needed to have by my side. All alone in this world. Not a partner or another dame to care for my loss. Tormented soul. Then again.
Oh, Ace. I'm sorry to barge in like this, but you're the only person I feel safe around right now.
She barged into my office, confused and in turmoil. What was I to do?
I need to talk to you about a personal matter.
I could tell she liked me. The way you can tell when the cards are about to fall in your direction. What can I do for y'all?
Oh, Ace. I just can't help the way I feel about you.
The feeling's mutual.
Oh. Well, excuse me!
Really? Maybe another time, Ace.
Oh, Scott. No, Scott. Ava.
I forgot my gun and... Here, take this stupid bench!
There I was, all alone and... Oh my God, who even cares anymore? A candlestick! It was her! Ava was right all along! I had to do the right thing! I'm sorry, it's not like that. You're under arrest for the murder of your husband, Geraldo Manuel Ortiz Calisto Riviera? My God, that really is a long name.
It wasn't me.
Oh, that's what they all say. They all play innocent, they all do. I'm not falling for that again. Let a triple homicide go last week. That's not happening again, I'm taking you downtown.
I knew it. I knew you'd get what's coming for you.
What is this? I don't understand.
I saw all the murder weapons in your purse, Scarlet, right down to the candlestick. I'm sorry about this. Really, I am, but as a man on the right side of the law, I have to do what's right and take you downtown. Why is it always the beautiful ones that are crazy? Seriously, why is it always the beautiful ones? They always at least have one screw loose. Why can't a beautiful one be sane for a change? Or have the crazy one at least be average looking? That'd make it easier on a guy. But I digress. Sorry, Scarlet. Looks like I have to take you downtown. Ladies.
Get revenge.
It was Catherine. It was Catherine!
Hold on. What were you ladies doing here anyway?
Oh, well, we were just munching on some cheese and having a glass of Chardonnay. Catherine brought the most delicious cheese platter. She's such a pleasant and delightful girl.
Cheese platter. Wait a minute. Milkshake?
I'm lactose intolerant.
You told me you were lactose intolerant. What else aren't you telling me?
All right, it was me.
That doesn't make any sense.
Quiet. She's in the middle of a confession. Damn, I'm good and handsome.
Catherine? How could you?
You see, Geraldo and I, we were lovers. And we were meant to be together for eternity. However, there was one major roadblock to our passion. My sister, Scarlet. Eventually, it reached the point where he couldn't stand the guilt of betraying his dear Scarlet. So he ended it.
You slept with my Geraldo? You tramp!
Hey! Ho! We don't have a full confession yet. Let's wait until she's finished, then you can attack her.
I was broken up. I felt like I had nothing else in the world. So I decided if I couldn't have him, no one could. I knew she would come to a detective when Geraldo croaked. So I made it a point to create false evidence. That's right. I staged a photograph that the photographer gave you. And I put all the murder weapons in Scarlet's purse. That way it would look like she killed him in wrath of jealous fury.
Well, that was easier than I expected. A full confession. The case is closed. You'll just have to come with me downtown, Catherine.
Over my dead body?
No, over his dead body.
I'm afraid you've missed the point. You see, now that you know, you must die. Any last words?
Well, actually...
I wasn't being serious. Goodbye, Mr. Roughbuckle.
What?
Hey, your boss. Need some help? Good thing I brought my gun, huh?
Oh, my heart won't take this.
Ava, it was you.
Well, Scarlet, looks like you're gonna have to find yourself some other schmuck.
But Ace...
Sorry, doll. That's just how the cards fall.
Well, I never... I'm too good for you anyways.
I don't understand.
Ava, you were always there for me. Literally, you were always there. But you were there for me. And you did save my life.
Well, of course I did, boss. I mean, not only are you my boss, but you're the man I admire the most.
I love you.
I love you too!
And that's how this one ends. Well, not really. You know how it ends. It's actually quite obvious.
Big scandalous.